And we're back. So last time we found out the identity of the beast, and no one was surprised at all who it was. But we have a whole lot of side missions that have opened up here, so we're gonna do a bunch of these today. Let's start with this one here.
Time for another episode of Zeke TV. You, my friend, will be my very special guest. A local TV station installed cheap and very hackable broadcasting dishes. You drain them, I'll jack them.
So this mission is essentially just an opportunity to use the lightning tether a lot. You know, you gotta have some missions, let you use some of your powers, and this one's pretty good. Let's just also, get some other powers sorted out here. Let's also forget that we even have the lightning tether. Let's do this the old-fashioned way. I mean, Cole can't get lazy. He needs to actually do some real climbing, too. I mean, I wouldn't want him to forget how to climb. I mean, if Cole forgets his moves, he could get all fat and lazy, and then all of a sudden, Infamous 3 is a game about building cars. And that'd just be silly. We can't have that. So yeah, you can also sort of use the lightning tether to save yourself from falls that you take no damage from. Well, you know, falling is inconvenient, and you can kinda, sorta, sometimes negate that. Then again, if you did fall, you can just tether back up, so it's not really a big deal. That's just another way it can save you from falls. Although, I kinda wish the lightning tether was implemented in a different way, rather than being, you know, the L2 power. I don't know how you would do it, but I wish it was done in a different way, so that it wasn't a thing that you have to actually aim and then fire. Like, you could just do it by pressing a button. That guy on the right does not know what he is doing. Oh, I missed you, Magnum Bolt.
Okay, I'm in. Get to a TV. Now this ought to put a few rumors to rest.
Single ladies of New Marais, time to put the rumors to rest. Yes, Cole McGrath is single and looking for love. Sure, you might have seen him running downtown, doing his best to act like a badass. But the simple truth is, man's a puppy dog on the inside. Loves all the standard crap, long walks on the beach, Russian ladies' hair, romantic picnics with cheese. And if you think you got what it takes to tame the heart of this proud warrior, give him a call. Will you be his greatest adventure?
Seek, you bastard.
So you know what's terrible about this mission? You do not get a single awkward-ass phone call from anybody in the city. Not even one! Missed opportunity, huh?
More plague victims are surfacing across the East Coast at a frightening rate. An estimated 50 million people are now infected with the disease, and every case so far has been fatal. Virologist Henry Marsh with the CDC told us more about what we're dealing with. The new plague is unlike anything they've seen before. He said the mysterious nature of the disease makes it nearly impossible to treat. The pathogen doesn't behave in conventional ways. It's neither bacterial nor viral. There have been no reports of cases outside the U.S., but the World Health Organization is already calling it a Phase 6 emerging pandemic and is preparing for the worst. The CDC warns that a vaccine could come too late. In light of these events, I've decided to take a leave of absence in order to spend a little more time with my family. I hope all of you can do the same. God bless you all. US TV News, signing off.
And that is the final news report that we'll be seeing in the game. So let's just pop down here and take care of this mission with this guy, who appears to be some kind of doctor, so we can lock another respawn spot.
Those Icemen ran off with some extremely volatile chemicals. They're gonna hurt someone.
We can't have that. I'm the one who does all the hurting in this town. Getting on my turf. So those volatile chemicals basically mean that they explode a lot when you shoot them. Let's try the spikers out for this level. I jump right through that. What? So we just gotta hit these guys with a couple of attacks. They'll just blow up. So obviously the sticky rocket is the way to go here, because it homes in. Also, it's kind of weird. This guy, you know, he said it was some kind of volatile chemical, but there doesn't seem to be any kind of a risk of anything. Nothing really hazardous or anything like that, apparently, so that's nice, I guess. Let's try to head this guy off. It looks like he might just be going right past here. There he is. Oh. Well, that could have been a terrible idea. But it wasn't. Also, as you would have it, there's a side mission right here. Well, let's just do this right now. I mean, right here, may as well. Where are you going? Come back.
There's some huge monsters tearing each other apart. This way.
Don't run from Cole. I'm not gonna hurt you. I would never think to do that.
People are gonna get trampled.
So this is just a big old scrape between the Icemen and... well... the swamp creatures. So, another Titan, of course. Gotta have one Titan per video now. At least. And I'm being silly and using the sticky rockets on the Titan. Well, you can see just how little damage they actually do to those guys now. I mean, I really pelted him there, and yeah, it didn't do too much. But let's just save the Titan for... Oh, hi. Let's save the Titan for last, I think, because there's a lot of other guys to kill down here, so let's take care of them first. Maybe try to wear him down a little bit. We won't finish him off right away. Fortunately, we can use this position on the building a little bit to just dole out some damage, but eventually we will have to get down there. Let's do this. Also, Afro Man there is very easily impressed. So this is a big fight with enemies that take a while to kill, so fast forwarding. Look, if it didn't take minutes and minutes to murder these slow-ass L to kill enemies, I wouldn't have to do this. Let's take this Titan out before we take the other guy out. Because he does not take long to take out with evil Cole. He is completely stuck. That's a thing that can happen sometimes in this mission. The Titan can just get stuck on one part of the roof and just wander around. But he's done. Also, it's kind of unfortunate, but just because of how the attacks the Titan and the swamp dude do, they don't really do a lot of damage to each other. which is kind of a shame. I wish they did, but whatever. It's okay. Just take care of this guy now, who's just kind of sitting down here doing nothing. But fortunately, devourers are really fast takeout by now. I mean, we're so beefed up with all these powers, these guys are not a problem anymore. That. So what's next? Well, let's do this mission right over here. It's right next to the next story mission, but not doing that one just yet. Oh, this is a perfect chance to use the lightning tether. It's a very nice power.
McGrath, my men saw an ICE gang courier heading for a warehouse we've had our eyes on. Go check it out, but don't let him see you.
So we have to do a little reconnaissance, I guess. Well, that's okay. Cole is really sneaky. I'm sure they won't notice this big red glowing man falling down to the warehouse. See, they didn't. Perfect stealth.
He delivered the package. Move in and blow them all away.
Okay. So the courier is actually not an ICE guy. He's actually like a normal dude. But that's alright. We're gonna murder his ass anyways. That was very good. You never expect a tornado to just burst through the wall of your warehouse. That's why it's such an effective tactic. Just mop up the rest of these guys. And that there would be the shipment the courier is going to drop off, I guess. Not a whole lot of guys left. That tornado was very effective. There he is. There's a courier right there. In his pink shirt. It's just a crusher. These guys aren't a big deal. Not anymore, they're not. Where are you? Up there? No? In the corner of the warehouse, I guess? Are you trying to hide? That's not gonna work. We get to keep the package ourselves, which of course would be some blast shards. Let's put that in butt. Alright, there we go.
No survivors.
Well, that's that. So what should we do next? Well, how about... How about we do the story mission? I mean, Zeke and the militia have worked so hard on setting up that lovely trap for Bertrand. Let's actually do that. Just have to get to the top of these buildings. This is where Bertrand's helicopter was supposed to land, but Zeke said he sabotaged it. we should be able to just ambush Bertrand and take him out.
Your chopper is going to be a little late.
Took you a while to find me, boy.
Selling Force conduits. Don't you have enough money already?
The world needs to experience firsthand the evil of our kind.
What? You're trying to scare people?
Yes. Conduits must be cleansed from this earth.
So you're gonna kickstart a genocide?
Conduits are an abomination.
Oh, do you really think that I'm the demon? The demon of Empire City?
No, Cole. I think we're both demons. Our pride has turned us into monsters.
I finally get it. Oh, you thought the race fear was gonna turn you into some sort of shiny superhuman. But instead, it turned you into a 50-foot maggot.
Cole, don't press me. If I turn into that thing again, oh, there will be blood on both our hands.
Blood? You're the one trying to trick humanity into killing anybody with a power.
Conduits are not part of the divine plan. They are a product of science, fueled by man's greed and the whispering of the devil in our ears, Cole.
See, that's where you're wrong, Bertrand. Conduits are monsters. No. See, powers don't kill people. Oh, no. It's the person behind the powers that kill people.
That's right.
Get on the back of my truck, man!
We're gonna lure him out of here!
Roche has an ambush all set up! Looks like he took the bait! Roche, you seeing this from your chopper?
Yeah, I'm catching it all! Bertrand's like a dumb animal when he's all monstered out. You guys are gonna lead him like a lamb to slaughter.
Yeah, Cole, let's not let the lamb get too close, okay? Bounce back that junk he's spitting at us, man! This truck ain't as tough as you are!
So Bertrand has this new power here where he'll shoot these, like, homing shots. Also this, you gotta make sure you hit him fast while he's doing this. But I don't know what Zeke was talking about there about the truck not being durable, because those shots will all aim right at Cole. They don't really go for the truck at all. And they don't do that much damage, as I was, demonstrating. Yes, demonstrating.
All his money's tied up in this ugly place!
Ah, you won't need it. Not after today.
Because we're gonna murder him to death. But his other attacks just don't have the range to hit the truck, so they're not really a problem. So we're almost at the ambush point. Just a little bit further. Lady, you might want to go home. Oh.
Incoming!
Well, I tried to warn her. I mean.
Race for impact! Yeah! Bullseye!
Hey, McGrath. You ever get used to this? All that crazy stuff you do?
Yeah. Not
salvo!
Almost there. Nix and Quo are waiting up ahead.
Along with some of my best men, we're about to unleash hell.
So there's lots of these big propane tanks everywhere, but they don't really seem to do anything to Bertrand. He'll just walk right through them without much problem, so. It's something, I guess. now it's time for the final battle with Bertrand. Got all... Oh. We got all hands on deck. He's just knocking us around. But the fight is essentially the same fight as it was before, but we just have a lot more help. And also, Bertrand doesn't really wander around like he did before. But he also has a lot more help, too. We do want to try to take some of these guys out, because they will get in the way when we're trying to shoot him. Let's not let that hit us either.
Still alive.
That is nasty. That cannot smell good. But despite having all this help, I don't think any of the people here can actually hurt Bertrand. I think that's all on us. At least I don't really see his health bar move too much, except when I'm shooting at him. Maybe they can hurt him, they just don't. Maybe the AI just gets all preoccupied with all these other guys. I don't know. So just like before, when you actually go to shoot his weak spots, you want to try to move. So let's try the sticky rocket on Bertrand. Because it'd be really good if that homed in on his weak spots, wouldn't it? It sure would, if that happened. So there's a lot of chances for friendly fire in this fight, as you'd probably expect. But it's okay, I don't think we can actually kill, like, Nyx or Quo by accident. So really the biggest problem with this fight, just like the last one, is getting knocked over when you try to hurt him. Because you really want as much uninterrupted time to shoot his weak spots as you can get. Oh, he's doing it again. Let's just try to get some damage there. Oh, there we go. So this is very similar to when we were on the truck.
Your buddy Zeke cooked up some do-it-yourself anti-Bertrand missiles. They'll do the job. Trouble is, we can't aim them for nothing. Yeah, we need to lead the monster into position to fire the missiles. Just try and keep him focused on it.
About those missiles, they're really big and slow.
What the hell happened? Okay, I think I know what's wrong. Never mind. Cole, can you blow up that missile?
Come on, he's everything I care for.
That did it!
So I'm not sure what makes these missiles anti-Bertrand missiles, but yeah, whatever, they're working, I guess. Yeah, this is basically the same as the truck, just you're on a helicopter now.
Missiles up!
Another gun, Pete.
I'm sorry. Look, do you know how to make missiles?
No.
Didn't think so.
I know how to make rockets out of lightning. That's pretty much the same thing. Look, do they blow up? Yeah. Do missiles blow up? Yeah, same thing. So I don't think we have to worry about the helicopter blowing up here. Like, I really don't know if he can blow it up.
All over the battlefield up ahead here.
Ah, blood. Somebody gets my style.
Oh god, Cole, your arms. Oh god. Cole, what happened?
Things are touchy.
So now it's phase two with Bertrand.
Leave this man dead. Come on, it's payback.
Pour it on.
So fighting Bertrand is a lot trickier with Evil Cole, just because he doesn't have the rapid fire. So you can't really do as much damage per second as Good Cole did. Quo, could you shoot at Bertrand, please? Like, the priorities. Come on. So sticky rockets are actually great against Bertrand, but they don't home in on his weak spots. But they are very good to use against his nipples. Oh, come on, those are his nipples. Come on now. What else could they be? But he's almost down. Let's try to avoid any distractions from any enemies right now. Let's just try to get some cleared out, and... Oh, he's going down again. Just a little bit more. Almost. Almost. Oh god. Quo is gonna need, like, several days of showers. That's,
Do it!
I'm doing it! I'm doing the thing! Okay, I think one more. Let's get infinite powers for this. Look, your sacrifice will not be in vain. I'm gonna blow Bertrand up real good for this. Oh, I didn't actually do it. I guess it was in vain. Oh well. There we go.
Now, Bertrand, not a conduit anymore.
Well, it took 30 men, 7 chainsaws, and 12 pickups, but we finally got that monster's corpse off the street. Thank you, McGrath. You've been an inspiration.
Plus, we have enough meat to feed the plague victims for months. Oh, this has been a very productive day, I say, as I stand on nothing. Look, Cole just learned how to fly. It's one of his powers.
Now that Bertrand's gone, the militia are falling apart, man. Some guys are still gung-ho, but I don't think I'll be picking up much more intel after today.
What? You got something?
Oh, yeah. How's another blast corps sound? Meet me near the dock on 3rd Street.
Zeke, you are the man.
That's what I keep telling people.